Welcome back to Friday Findings. If you are new here, hi, my name is Sylvia and I blog and I vlog about health through optimal diet and nutrition and healthy lifestyle. I run a blog, bigcitymom.com, so be sure to check it out. Friday Findings are short videos with a lot of useful information. So this week, let's talk about our natural defenses against lectins. Let's get started. On Wednesday, I made a video about lectins, what they are and what do they do to our bodies once they get to our bloodstream. None of it is particularly good. The video is linked up here. You should definitely check it out. Now let's talk about our three natural defenses against lectins. Well, first of all, we learned to reduce amount of lectins in our foods by soaking, cooking, sprouting, and fermenting. But once we ingest the food, it will hit our stomach and it will, lectins will meet our gastric acid. And if we have good stomach acid, it will break down some of the lectins. Then, number two, lectins will travel to our gastrointestinal tract and will meet our mucus layer. And if we have strong, healthy mucus, it will absorb the food that we need, but it will not allow lectins to get into our bloodstream. Then, number three, lectins will travel to further down to meet our bacterial flora, and that gut bacteria will safely dispose of lectins. Okay, so these are the three natural defenses we have against lectins: our gastric acid, mucus layer, and bacterial flora. Now, those of us that have gut issues or autoimmunity might have all three dysfunctional, or maybe one or two of them dysfunctional, but either way, you will be better off being on a diet that is devoid of foods rich in lectins. Okay, this will do it for this week's Friday Findings. Please like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!